The universe is a vast and complex place that in many ways we still don't understand. We exist on this relatively tiny rock called Earth, floating around a relatively average star, the Sun. And with the help of modern technology, we've only just begun to explore even a tiny part of the space that surrounds us. Given our modest cosmic standing, then, it's incredible to think that even if we were to somehow explore the entirety of the universe, there might still be more out there. But this is Unveiled, and today we're setting sail to travel the multiverse, and this time through the lens of Hindu cosmology. Do you need the big questions answered? Are you constantly curious? Then why not subscribe to Unveiled for more clips like this one, and ring the bell for more thought-provoking content. If you're a fan of science fiction, superhero movies, pretty much anything nowadays, then you're probably familiar with the multiverse. The theory that we're all living in only one of possibly infinite parallel universes. And while there's no confirmed scientific consensus as to whether or not the multiverse, in any of its many guises, is true, it is a concept that has crossovers into faith as well. So for today's video, we're assessing the multiverse as conceived in Hindu cosmology. To understand this multiverse, it's helpful to first consider other aspects of Hindu mythology. For example, there's an important distinction made here between matter and spirit. In Hinduism, the universe is composed of both of these things, with the main difference being that matter is physical and can therefore be destroyed, whereas spirit is non-physical and can so never be destroyed. For Hindus, the physical, material part of existence is then an illusion. And so it follows that the ultimate goal of Hinduism is to reach enlightenment, a level of existence at which one can see through the illusion and realize that all material things are temporary and that the spirit is always more important. The cyclical nature of existence is another major and well-known theme in Hinduism, and ultimately it's another key aspect to the Hindu multiverse. The idea is that all material things go through three main phases of creation, preservation, and destruction. Therefore, again, the physical part of the universe, all things that we can see, feel, hear, and so on, must eventually be destroyed. These three phases are often represented by three of the most prominent Hindu gods: Brahma the creator, Vishnu the preserver, and Shiva the destroyer. And it's believed that the interactions between these three are what fundamentally result in a many-layered reality of multiple universes, a multiverse. In Hindu tradition, the lifespan of the universe corresponds to the lifespan of Brahma, at the end of which Brahma dies and the universe is destroyed with him. Fortunately, though, even after the death of the universe, all is not lost, and a new universe is born out of the ashes of the old. In this way, it's sometimes argued that Hindu cosmology has some similarities with modern scientific theories regarding the universe. Hinduism essentially holds that everything is born from a single point, much like it is in the Big Bang theory. It then posits that everything eventually collapses into that same point, which comes close to another floated scientific prediction for our universe's fate, known as the Big Crunch. What's most important, though, is that because a new creation always follows from destruction in Hinduism, destruction isn't considered a bad thing. After all, the god Shiva, the destroyer, has a divine duty to end the universe in order to pave the way for a new one, and he's worshipped for doing so. Which brings us back to that distinction between matter and spirit. Matter, remember, can be destroyed, but that's fine because the spirit continues. The Hindu multiverse, in one sense then, refers to the fact that the universe is not a single space, but rather infinite spaces occurring one after another. But perhaps even more significantly, across various Hindu texts, there's mention not just of one universe that goes through this cycle of birth, death, and rebirth, but rather many. In some cases, it's suggested that there's an endless number of universes that all coexist at the same time. It's variously said that these universes float around just like atoms do from our perspective, and that each one contains its own Brahma, Vishnu, and Shiva, its own story of birth, preservation, and destruction. It's said that each universe consists of many unique layers too, including earth, water, fire, air, and sky, to add more detail. But despite these structural similarities, each universe has the potential to be unique. By hosting different creatures, for example, different environments, cultures, and perhaps different rules of nature. And some universes even come with other universes contained inside them. The possibilities are essentially endless then. As such, there are many myths and legends in the ancient texts that refer back to the multiverse, making use of the many, many variations that it offers. So now we have the idea that each individual universe is moving through a repeating cycle from birth to rebirth, and the idea that this is happening across countless multi-layered, multiple universes that exist on a higher level. You'd perhaps think that the structure of reality must end there, but there's one final concept to incorporate. In the ancient texts, the Puranas, the mythology goes into detail about 14 further worlds, or lokas, that also contribute to the multiverse total. There is some debate as to whether lokas are intended to be taken literally as physical realms or if they're meant as symbolic representations of different levels of consciousness, but in either case, they play a major role. The lokas are located on different planes of existence, with 7 forming the heavens, or upper worlds, and 7 forming hell, or the underworlds. Those belonging to the upper worlds are known as the Viharitis, and the highest of all of them is the Satyaloka, which is held to be the home of truth and is also where Brahma is said to live. The upper lokas then descend through various levels, all containing various supreme and good deities, until we get back to Earth, which is the first and lowest of the upper worlds. From here, though, we can descend further into the lower 7 lokas, which are called the Patalas. At the lower stages, we encounter various demons and malevolent forces, until we finally arrived at the lowest and worst level, the Naga Loka. To move from top to bottom of the lokas, then, is a journey from wisdom and enlightenment to immorality and sin. And with Earth situated close to the center, it's easy to see that the lesson contained here is that we, mere human beings, can wind up rising or falling depending on the actions we take during our lives. So now we have a full and rich picture of the Hindu reality. Let's recap. First, there's the idea that the universe moves through a cycle of births and rebirths, producing new universes every time. This cycle is guided by the gods Brahma, Vishnu, and Shiva, and carries on indefinitely. Second, we have the idea that this cycle is happening across endless universes, not just this one, that exist on a higher plane of reality. These multiple universes are many-layered and are self-contained. Third, and finally, inside each of these many cyclical universes, there's a fundamental structure of lokas, split across 14 levels in total. Earth itself is in the middle, but there are many other realms above and below Earth, too, the highest of which promises peace, the lowest of which promises torment. For the most part, the myths and legends suggest that traveling across the multiverse is difficult, if not impossible, and many of those who do achieve it only do so with the help of at least one divine being. But to finish, we'll again highlight the distinction made at the top of this video between physical matter and the non-physical spirit. When considered against the backdrop of the multiverse, we encounter the possibility that the spirit can go to places that are otherwise impossible for our physical bodies to reach. We're imbued with consciousness, imagination, and emotions like love, fear, and hope. It's these that color or cloud our experience of life, and it's perhaps through these that we can gain a greater understanding. The multiverse in Hindu cosmology is perhaps then as much a spiritual concept as it is a physical one. There are elements of it that share similarities with emerging theories in physical science, yes, but to truly explore this particular version of the multiverse, you must prepare for a journey deep into your soul. Navigate that journey well, and enlightenment can be yours. What do you think? Is there anything we missed? Let us know in the comments, check out these other clips from Unveiled, and make sure you subscribe and ring the bell for our latest content.